Ah, space. It's a pretty weird place, isn't it? Whether it's timey-wimey, upside-down stuff, strange exoplanets that rain torrential downpours of pure glass, entire cosmic oceans of neon gas, white dwarfs, red dwarfs, or perhaps the weirdest, most mysterious linchpin of all these space-time shenanigans combined, the black hole. The void itself, the dark maw of the universe, the biggest fan of theoretical spaghettification of all time, and I do mean all time, because as we all know, time is a relative concept, right? Or is it a flat circle? I forget. But anyway, what if we took that mysterious cosmic void, threw caution to the wind and, I don't know, dropped a nuke in it? Just for the sake of it, really? What would happen? Well, let's find out. Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if we nuked a black hole? Roll the clip. For the curious amongst you, that clip was, of course, from 2009's Star Trek, directed by J.J. Abrams, because, you know, this is a video about black holes. And you deserve nothing better than the most cinematic visual depiction going. Or, well, the most appropriate, I guess. Anyway, it leads us to an important notion, because the fact of the matter is, despite their best efforts, fiction has tried its damnedest to try and visually theorize exactly what's going on down in the deep, dark bowels of a black hole. But the reality remains that no one exactly knows what would happen if we plummeted headlong into the void. It could be a portal to another dimension, but it also could be a cosmic trash compactor that obliterates matter with its infinite density. But sometimes, as they often say, the truth is stranger than fiction. You see, the conceptual idea behind black holes has permeated its way across the scientific community for over 200 years, culminating recently with the first ever actual visual photograph of the coveted black hole. We took a photo of it, guys, and that's awesome. If you didn't know, though, the first ever mention of something resembling a black hole was way back in 1783, theorized by a Cambridge don by the name of John Mitchell, who had written a paper in the Philosophical Transactions of the Royal Society of London about what he referred to as dark stars. Mitchell noted that any star that was sufficiently massive and compact would inevitably have such a strong gravitational field that even light itself could not escape. Well, of course, he was right, but it wasn't until 1915 when a particularly brilliant mind, our boy Albert Einstein, put forward his revolutionary general theory of relativity, and suddenly space and time were no longer thought of as independent entities, but instead just different metrics of a single object, space-time. And now it was all neatly mashed together. Space-time wasn't flat like the previous two parameters. It was warped and curved by the massive manner of matter and energy bounded across the cosmic expanse. And those curves and warps were dictated by the endless indents upon them and inside them, black holes. The result of what happens when a star gets too big for its boots and its density becomes even bigger than the Beatles. Well, of course, he was right, and he sparked an interest in another particularly brilliant mind, Professor Stephen Hawking, who dedicated his cosmic joy of life to figuring out pretty much anything and everything of what the hell is going on with all these black holes. But guess what? Despite the indifference of Professor Hawking, we're going to theoretically send a nuke into one. But the first question is, which one? How many black holes are there? How are we even going to get into the position of shooting a nuclear rocket into it? Surely it's not as easy as firing off a missile from the surface of our planet and hoping for the best, right? Well, wrong. Of course, space is big, guys. Heck, our galaxy, the Milky Way, is really, really big, as in 180,000 light years in diameter. And bad news, because the nearest theorized black hole to our pale blue dot is 3,000 light years away. The fastest thing that we've ever created is the Helios 2 probe, which was launched way back in 1976 and traveled at a record speed of over 157,000 miles per hour, and incredibly enough, is still in orbit around our sun today. Now, 157,000 miles per hour is incredibly, incredibly quick, but when compared to traveling the distance of a single light year, yeah, it doesn't look too hot, does it? To travel one single light year at 157,000 miles an hour would take 4,269 years. And unfortunately for us, the nearest black hole, as we said, is 3,000 light years away. Guys, I hate to break it to you, but even if we sent a nuke right now that could travel at the speed of Helios 2, it would take 12,807,000 years to even conduct our experiment. And, well, as they say, ain't nobody got time for that. In fact, if black holes were cosmic portals to another dimension, it's entirely hypothetical that if we sent off our nuke and 12 million years passed for us to find out what happened, humanity and our planet could have come and gone, and we'd have disappeared entirely, lost in the sands of time, before we even found out the result. And perhaps we'd have never found out that our nuke that we haphazardly shot into another dimension actually landed smack bang into another planet, destroying it completely. It's the perfect crime, really, but we all know better than that, don't we? We don't just shoot off nukes without considering the potentially destructive consequences. So let's say that our civilization had finally figured out faster than light space travel, and a team of scientists headed over to our galaxy's nearest black hole with a nuke strapped to their vessel. They position themselves at a safe enough distance out of the gravitational pull of its event horizon, they hit the big red button, and the nuclear bomb plummets its way into the black hole. And what happens? Well, under our current understanding of physics, absolutely nothing. But not in the way that you may think. You see, within a black hole's event horizon, energy and matter become one, and those very same black holes can convert any varying degree of energy into mass. It gets bigger, guys. It's a black hole. And as we know, a black hole's mass is infinitely dense. Anything that happens in our universe, nuclear detonation included, denotes information, and thus information requires energy, and energy has mass. E equals mc squared. And, well, a nuclear bomb has a hell of a lot of energy. In fact, a 1 megaton nuclear weapon releases energy equivalent to 4.18 times 10 to the power of 15 joules. While that's absolutely massive, that's only small fry comparative to the largest nuclear weapon ever detonated, the Tsar bomber created by the USSR with a yield of over 50 megatons. Whatever the degree of magnitude, if we fired our hypothetical nuke into a black hole, the likely outcome is that it would just add fuel to its fire. Our gigantic explosion would serve only to convert that entire dense and enormous mass into pure, unbridled energy, and again, as is the mechanics of a black hole, convert that energy back into mass. You see, it wouldn't matter how many nukes we sent into it, or how powerful they were, because in all reality, we could crash an entire star into a black hole, and it would still gobble the whole thing up, only getting bigger and bigger, chewing up the universe as it goes. Thankfully for us though, Professor Stephen Hawking theorized that black holes eventually dissipate their mass over a long enough passage of time. Given enough breathing space, even the most supermassive of black holes will eventually evaporate away into a harmless soup of particles. Well, theoretically, anyway. So for the time being, it's probably best to not fire any nukes into a black hole, or anything really, except an asteroid hurtling towards our planet. Yeah, we can nuke that. Safety first. Well, there we have it, our sort of answer to that burning question, what if we nuked a black hole? What do you guys think? Do you agree that it's probably best to leave them alone? Yeah. Well, let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Before we depart from today's video, let's take a quick look at some of your more entertaining edifications from over the past few days. First up, in relation to our recent SCP-3000 vs. Yormangandia video, Dracos514 says, I'm sure I'm not the only one to correct this, but it's pronounced Yormungand. Sorry, pal. I mean, you can call the world serpent whatever you like, but under both Old Norse and Icelandic, it's Jormungandr, although my dialect is admittedly abysmal. By all means though, whatever works for you, buddy. You just do you, Dracos514. Good job. Well, on that note, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Just stick around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe button. We'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.